Warning, you've never seen anything like this before. The following program is intended for mature audiences. This program contains alcohol and strong language. Viewer discretion is advised.
Take trips, bitch, don't let it take you. Yep, yep. I'm due for a vacay, all you bitches say. I'm a first class ticket, nigga, fully paid. We want trips, wipes, and private jets. And wanna land, don't expect no sex. Nope. And I got my purse, the bartender, too. She's top notch, she fitting with the crew. It's actually a 2-for-1 special, boo. Oops, I forgot, that's my job for two. Wrestle everywhere I go. Fine when it dies, she keep it on the low. I wear plain hats, eyes, you can see. She lay in my tongue, get her icy. Ooh. You ain't saying shit, you're acting spicy.
Welcome to Amberella's World, the official bartending show where getting lit is it, because this is as raw and unscripted as it's going to get. I'm your host, Amberella, and I have everybody's favorite bad boy with me.
Hey.
I got Mocity Jaybee with me today. Yeah. What's up, my guy?
What's up?
Hot as hell.
It is hot as fuck out here. We out here in Dallas, but I'm from Houston. I love Dallas. You know what I'm saying? It's Mocity Jaybee. Motherfucking pretty guy, you know what I'm saying? The bad boy savage. I ain't just a regular bad boy, I'm a savage. I told him from day one I was a savage.
Yeah, we already know. Well, so, wait, can I call you mama?
That's cool. All everybody right. Just be coming over. I'm like,
I wonder if we're gonna be cool with that.
Cool.
I gotta know. So, you know, I research you and shit. Mm-hmm. What the hell? You are like a mystery. What is your real name?
Oh, damn.
I
make sure nobody knows my government name.
You have it on lock, okay?
I know. It's gonna stay on lock.
I mean, you did that shit because no one can find it.
I know. I don't want my name. And I actually go by other names. I never use my real name, so.
Yeah?
Everybody called me JB. All
right. JB. So where did the name come from? Did it come from your government name?
My name is Mocity Jaybee. Mocity is Missouri City, Texas, where I'm from. But if you're from there, you call it Mocity. So every time somebody calls me Mocity or Mo anything, y'all saying where I'm from. You know what I'm saying? Putting on for my city. And JB is my initials. You know what I'm saying? So everybody call me JB. All right.
Yeah. I was wondering.
She tried to get that out of me. Nobody ever asked me that, though.
Yeah. Good. I'm glad I coached you off guard with that one, because I said, didn't see my first couple questions. Because I was going in. I said, what the hell? I'll give up.
Correct.
All right. So I feel like Bad Boys Texas was really the funniest season I've seen so far.
Yeah.
So, I gotta know, is Orlando like that with the cameras off, too?
Orlando, man, this is what I want to say about Orlando. That's my brother. He's one of the people on the cast that I actually connected with. He's a spiritual man. He got a family. You know what I'm saying? He got a wife and kids. He really nice in person. A lot of people be talking about him and saying he be on drugs and shit. He don't be on the fucking drugs. He be turned up and he like to drink. But he has a strong personality, though. Like, he's just hilarious. And it was an honor to work with that man, bro. Like, if he ever called me for anything, like, I got him.
Yeah.
Vice versa too. He didn't give me this ring, but he gave me a diamond. He gave me a diamond ring while we was filming, and he gave me some Jordans while we was filming. Like, he really.
Oh,
nice.
Y'all really do fuck with each other. Y'all really bros.
He fucked with me hard. Well, all of them really fucked with me. I just didn't fuck with some of them.
Yeah, I feel you. It is. Shit, we can get on everybody. You know what I mean?
He turned up in person for sure. He turned up.
So, JB, you gotta tell me, what does it take to be a bad boy in your opinion?
In my opinion, a bad boy is shit. I ain't no fucking bad boy. I'm a savage. Like, that's just a name. Like, that's just a little acronym. I've been on some other shit. Like, I've been loud and lit way before I was on TV. You know what I'm saying? People always thought I was some other way, but now they see me on TV and they see, like, nah, I'm really like this. Like, it ain't no facade. But I don't know. I feel like you gotta be yourself. You gonna fight. Like, you gotta throw them hands. You gonna be a bad boy.
Yeah.
It's about turning up and having fun and just not giving a fuck, but really being yourself and standing on yourself. Because everybody that was a bad boy, we all got our own different personalities. We all stand on different shit. We all do different things. So, I mean.
Y'all definitely, I can definitely see all y'all different personalities.
Yeah. I think I was the chillest. I'm the chillest one out of all of the niggas for sure.
Did you think that? You thought you was chilling for real.
I'm a chill ass nigga, but being around chaos like that will make you do some shit. Like, it's real, like, the energy is real tense. Being around a fucking scene like that, like, just people like that, man, it'll bring something out of you to make you do something or make you want to fight too. Like,
right.
It's just crazy. It's hectic. It was fun.
So, do you think you'll carry this savage bad boy mentality for like ever? You think you'll ever drop it?
It's not even that. It's just like kind of who I am, like inside. Like I can be a whole different way, like. But that bad boy shit, it just that's just the show. That's just for the check.
Okay.
In real life, I'm
savage.
Really, I'm really like that. That's in real what life. It is. That's just what I call it. I always have accepted. I'll be on some savage shit. Like,
you think you'll be a 50-year-old grandpa being like, I'm still savage.
Yeah.
You gonna be like that?
Yeah.
Nah. Yeah. Grandpa JB gonna be out here talking about your savage.
This shit ain't going nowhere. you can change and grow and just learn how to control and maintain stuff.
Yeah.
Know? It's still there.
All right, so I feel like on this show you had it out for like Prince and Adonis. Tell me, what makes you just be like, nah, I'm about to fuck you up?
Okay, so prior to the show, I didn't know nobody.
Okay.
I spoke with Jonathan before back in the day. Like I said, I've been doing my thing way before TV, and I was on TV before Zeus. This is just my first reality shit. I didn't know nobody. I didn't have no beef with nobody. Nobody had beef with me. Nobody wanted to fight me. Everybody else had their own beef. So I didn't know nobody. So coming into the house, I'm just one deep, standing tall around all these motherfuckers. But I'm listening to the directors and the people that's paying me, telling me what to do. And when the cameras cut on, everybody else do all type of different shit. Like,
yeah,
they be faking, and then when the cameras cut on, they might do something crazy or catch you off guard. It's just, I don't know. But I'm saying all that to say, I never had a problem with Prince. We cool in real life. We still talk to this day. You know what I'm saying? He bought something for my son. We lived together. Like, we actually had our own house one time while we was filming. They didn't show it, but we always had a back house at the big ass houses we had. We lived together. We worked out together. You know what I'm saying? We cool. If he ever called me, I got him. If I call him, he got him. But I ain't never had no problem with him. But sometimes when we film, he'll be talking shit. And I'm like, Prince, bro, like,
Yeah, I used to catch up like, nigga, don't do that to my boy,
because
he...
Don't get me wrong, he gonna fight you back, like, if you try to fight him, but, like, it's just, like, niggas don't be having them hands for me, like, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
And I'm cool, I'm not just gonna just dry beat nobody up, because I'm actually cool with him, but I did steal off on a few niggas. And I didn't have a problem with Adonis either, I didn't know Adonis, everybody else in the house knew him prior, I promise you I didn't know him. I said, bro, you know what, I haven't fought nobody. And people think this is dumb for doing this, but in my head, it's like, nigga, this is what you signed the contract to do.
Right, so
it's
like,
I can go dry ass, get down with somebody in the house who don't want to fight me, or this new person, fuck it. I'm like, whoever walked the dumb, I'm a whoop him. But Chef D ended up having beef with him prior that I didn't know about, so they fought first. So that made it look like when I stole up on him, I just did it for no reason, or I'm being a hoe, when really, nigga, I'm gonna steal up on you regardless, bro. And I'm not gonna ever be like, hey, I want a one-on-one with you, sir. What's up? No, nigga. Look alive.
And he came in talking shit. So it was like, you know?
Yeah, and everybody think, I beat him up on the gloves for sure, but everybody's on the internet trying to play with me like I didn't whoop his ass while we fist fought. I gotta understand like how these cameras is angled. Man, stop playing with me, bro. And bro's pulling on my clothes and shit. You see, when ain't no security in the way, ain't no, you can't grab my clothes, we in that ring. It's just man versus man. You see, he was all fight. You know
I seen it. I don't know what the fuck they was talking about.
Man. I just had to address that shit. They cool. I don't got no problem with them. Yeah. I have problems with real niggas in the streets and shit that I would have to really worry about. I'm not worried about these niggas.
That's little shit.
Man, that's why I be trying to tell them like that female message shit. Y'all do that over there. Keep me out of it. I shouldn't have even punched your ass if I knew it was gonna come with all of this shit.
Right.
Man, I don't want nothing to do with none of that. I'm just here to make a check and do my thing. Hey, that's it.
So Mo, do you feel like you get mad easily?
Nah, I don't get mad easy. It take, if somebody disrespect me or put their hands on me, I'll beat that ass, but that don't necessarily make me just mad. Cause even when I fought them niggas, I wasn't mad. We didn't have no beef. You know what I'm saying? We just dropped on it. But it was for a show. It's all for a reason. You know what I'm saying?
It was the fucking energy. It was all the way off when he came in.
Bro, imagine if him and Chef D just fought. That was him and Chef, that's it. But me stealing off on him and us fighting made it just go crazy.
Right.
I like, nigga, you getting your clout off fighting Mo City Jaybee on TV, my nigga. Remember that?
Definitely.
And the rest of the niggas was scared to fight his ass. For sure.
Oh, I know.
For sure.
I'm like, oh my goodness. It was, what's his face for me? What's his name?
I fuck with Arado.
Yeah, he's cool. But I just feel like once he did the double fight with what's his face who left and got sick, he wasn't trying to fight nobody no more.
Well, his logic was like, he not finna fight nobody after 2-3 people that fought him type shit. That was his logic on it. But I think, like I said, they knew him prior to the show. So I don't know none of these people. So I'm just out the loop.
Oh, man, I get it.
Man, I get
it.
Yeah,
let's get into, all right, fuck Bad Boys. Let's get into Under the Influence shit. So, describe Mocity Jaybee Under the Influence. Me? Do you ever catch yourself slipping?
Ooh, fuck no, I ain't ever slip. I be on some demon time when I be drinking. That's what I'm telling you. I be on some other shit. If I start drinking, oh my God, I might really do what I be thinking about doing for real. But I'm fun too.
Yeah.
And a lot of people don't know, like, I'm so chill, they don't think I'm fun. I'm fun in a bitch. I just have to be comfortable around you. Like, I be in a room full of 100 people and I be quiet as hell. But if I be around 10 people that make me comfortable, I'm wilding up. You see my personality. Like, she cool, so she's seeing a little bit of me, you know?
Yeah, I'm fucking with it. Mom, that's right. So, with you being a rapper, you've been writing music for a while now, I see. Have you ever wrote a song drunk before and it was a fucking hit?
I've never recorded a song sober, to be honest. I'm sorry. God forgive me. In the studio, like, I make music off how I feel. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I gotta have me a couple drinks, maybe some drink. I'm for sure gonna be smoking. I'm gonna be smoking at the mic. Like, man, I gotta get out of my body because I gotta help me open up at this point in my life, in my music career. Like, I'm more so like trying to open up more about my feelings and how I see my life and what I do on the track instead of just a lot of the old shit I used to put out with. I'm a big artist. I'm a pretty big artist, bigger than what people be thinking too.
You definitely are. I think the things you work with, I see how long you've been out here, man. So
I'm making some moves. Hey, look.
I don't think a lot of people know that.
Yeah, they don't. But it's like people think I just came out the blue because of Zeus. But it's like, no, you type my name in. I ain't gonna lie, type my name in. You're gonna see some crazy ass shit. Don't believe the hype. Don't believe this internet shit. You can put anything on the internet. But when you go to them accolades, hey, it's some good accolades up there that's like, shit. And I did that with no help. And this shit, working hard, get you up here with being on Zeus and shit. But I mean, anybody could probably be on there. But
speaking of songs, come on, I know you didn't think that bigger in Texas.
I thought it was kind of live.
For real. Yeah. It is catchy though, I ain't gonna lie.
Yeah, and then I hopped on that hoe too.
I know you did. That's why I was like, is he just going with the flow? Or did he really think that shit was hard?
I was just going with the flow. I thought it was pretty cool. You know, it's funny, I just saw Really 2 nights ago. He lived in Houston too. I just seen him. Yeah, Really pretty cool. I'm pretty cool with everybody. Like, nobody want a problem with me. Like,
I know that.
But I'm really cool with Orlando. Me and Jonathan, we some Texas niggas, we cool. People don't know, but me and Carrion are really cool.
Shit,
I forgot
Carrion.
Damn. That's my nigga. Huh?
I forgot Carrion.
Yeah, that's my nigga. We was filming. He the only person that talked about God with me. Like, I'm real spiritual. He was the only person. He had his Bible. And when we would talk, he would go to the scriptures for proof. Like, he would read. I'm like, damn, like, that shit made me feel good. Because I'm telling you, filming that shit, like, it's all funny games. It look, this part of it. But, like, filming that shit, that shit was kind of draining. It was crazy.
I feel like people be sleeping on Gary. I feel like, just because they had his little incident wherever he got going on with his motherfucking dad, like, that don't got shit to do with nothing. That's a family issue.
Yeah, but people gonna always use what they can use against you, you know? Right. He cool, though. That's my nigga. I cut for him. And like I said, me and Prince pretty cool, like.
Yeah, he seems like a cool dude.
Everybody else is high and by.
Definitely. Hi. I was wondering, I'm like, I wonder if Mo really just hop on this track. I'm like, all right, I'm going with the
song.
Like,
we made a real song, though.
I like that one, though.
Yeah, it was cool.
That one's bomb.
I didn't have no type of control. It was in my head, it's like, okay, whenever it's my turn, I'm just gonna do my thing. Like,
right.
I'm not gonna tell them what to do, what beats pick.
I'm just
I'm just enjoying the moments. Like, it's just another moment.
Yeah.
I just came to do my thing.
I was fucking with that.
That's what they paid me to do, is just come do my thing.
All right, so what's one of your wildest nights that you woke up and was like, damn? Jaybee and liquor is like real dangerous right now.
One of my wild. Okay, I'll give y'all a night. And I'm not even gonna give y'all my wildest night. But recently in Dallas, me and my niggas got into a fight. Some bitch ass nigga stole off on my partner. And I'll never lie to y'all, right hand to God. Some bitch ass nigga stole off on my partner. And we beat they motherfucking ass. I broke a Jack Daniels bottle like this big. I ordered, when we went out, we ordered the biggest bottles. Yeah, we really lit. I'm spending some of that Zeus money. But I broke a bottle like this big on their head. And I woke up the next morning like, damn, I really broke a bottle on their head in front of everybody. I was just mad nobody got it on camera, bro. But yeah, we beat the shit out of them. It was bad.
Why the other trial?
I don't know. Niggas be thinking shit sweet in person, but niggas just stole off on my partner. And, oh my God, we was beating the shit out of them dudes, bro. In Dallas, inside the club. Right after I got done hosting this shit. It was crazy.
What do niggas be beefing over? They just be hating?
Niggas really be. It's funny because niggas and females behave. Females behave on me too. Like females, go look in the comments. A lot of them be females. And what's crazy, it's only black people. There's no white people, Chinese. No, nobody hating on me. It's only
not the black folks hating on you all.
Go look in the comments. It's only black people.
Don't let me go to the club with you and that female. It's alright.
No. See, in person. Mocity, oh my God.
Yeah.
Hey, what's up, bros? Man, on the internet, they be. But in person, they show respect. But I'm saying, we had to whoop nigga ass. He ain't still up on me, still up on my partner. We just mm-hmm. But not in person, people be mad respectful. Like, really respectful.
You can tell the fake.
Nah, it can be fake or not. Right. They just be. They don't be on this. Because in person, I don't give off like no pussy ass nigga. Like, mm-hmm. In person, my demeanor and my action, I carry myself like I'm not fucking playing. Like,
right.
Don't play with me. Like, people be playing, especially on that internet. For real, bro.
So, with you having kids, do you want to expose them to this life, or you don't want them to be out here doing this and they, you know?
My son, man, it's not even about exposing, because my son know what I do. I just had a fresh baby. He not even a month old yet. Oh. I got two boys, and I'm raising some kings. my son, he know what I do, but I don't let him watch what I do. He just know I'm on TV and stuff, but... Mm. I mean, when they grow up, they not gonna, the apple don't fall too far from the tree. They might be bigger than me and what I do. Hey, shit, my little nigga can box already. I got some beautiful sons. I've got high little daughters, but I want a little girl.
You want a girl? You want to try for a girl?
I keep getting boys.
It'll come. Why should there be a girl? Why should there be a girl, bro?
Oh, wait, you got kids?
I do. I have a son.
You keep asking me all the questions.
I do got a son. He's 12 though.
So how do you feel about the show? Because me personally, even while we was filming it, I was telling them like, bro, this gonna be one of the best shows y'all drop. Like y'all gonna look back and watch this shit just off the character. They just mad because we wasn't fighting 24/7, but like
I wasn't from
that. I feel like we gave them a real show. Like
yeah.
with different things that we did, bonding, sports, fighting. Like we had some hardcore fights, I ain't gonna lie.
You know what I mean? And even when Orlando was crying, like, yo, this is a brotherhood.
No, but he dead serious because he grew up rich, so he probably never been around niggas like us. He would tell me, even off camera, he'd be like, man, young nigga, da da da. He's like, man, I just can't believe. I'm like, nigga, I can't believe I'm with you. I can show you.
It's crazy, you know, because I'm like, yo, nothing happened to Orlando Brown here in the mix with all of y'all.
And I'm like, of course, there's other people that's not up there like that on the show, too, but like everybody who got there, like they did their thing, but I'm like, sometimes I just catch myself like drunk. We turned up and I just look around. I just be like, damn, I'm with Jonathan. This nigga been famous for it. I'm with fucking Eddie from That's So Raven, nigga.
Right.
I'm like, damn. And they looking at me like, nigga, you live. But I'm like, bro, y'all niggas legends, bro.
Yeah. And you whoop the ass.
I'm sorry. Me and my nigga Jonathan too locked in. We'll never fight each other. Like, that's bro for real. Like,
yeah, I can't even see
you. I kind of thought that they would want us to because me and him got the best hands on the show. But like, we on some real shit. Like, nigga, we not finna fight each other on camera. And if we is, they better give us $100K because we got that much respect for each other.
Right.
When he cut on the cameras, niggas do weird shit. But
can y'all like refuse it though if they wanted y'all to fight? You gonna be like, no, we're not doing that.
You gonna be running on there like Carry On, running on the show. Sometimes be like, Carry On, why you be doing some of the shit you be doing, bro?
Brad be pissing me off the whole season. I just thought he was wild. He just didn't
fit in. He's so cool in person. Though.
Isn't he?
But like, being around him, he was, but some of the shit you gotta understand, they know what they doing when they doing it. And I feel like he's never been around, even though he was in B2K and all this shit he was doing, he never been around no real niggas. So he would come on set tweaking, tripping, and then a nigga got punch him in his mouth for tripping. But I was just showing y'all got so much.
I just feel like he needed like, that though. I really think that was meant for him to be on the show for him to get punched in his fucking shit. He's never experienced that, like you said. He ain't been around no real niggas. He ain't been around nothing.
But he would come around like, okay, I'll give you an example. We'll be at the house in Austin and Raz B gets special treatment. He's an executive producer. He's in the hotels while we're in the house. He ain't gotta find nobody for a room. He don't gotta try. So he come to the set. We all got a call time when it's time to start shooting. And when we shoot, it's always, you get lucky if it's only like 5-6 hours. It's really like 12 hours straight. Man, they'll come on set already drunk. And it's 1 o'clock and we just waking up. Or they'll come, and I don't know if they smoking, I don't know if they sniffing, I don't know what they doing, but they'll come on the set fucked up and we just looking around like, nigga, you tripping. And then he'll say some, nigga, I ain't scared of you, bitch ass nigga. Nigga, all right, woo, woo. Nigga like, what?
He don't say the shit's over. He ain't gonna say that shit's sober. I'm telling you, he drinks so he can talk like that. Because he not gonna talk like that.
I fuck a Raz B though. We got a song coming out. I fuck it's because they fuck with me.
He was the worst character for me. I would bad for every time he came on. I'm like, yo, this nigga needs to be off this show.
Well, you know what? I'm gonna go back and rewatch this shit and try to act like I'm not.
Do y'all watch the show when it's aired?
Yes, we all do.
Okay.
Because we got to see what people talking about. People talking about us like crazy, and we finished this 2 months ago. We moving on. Right. Y'all just catching on.
Yep.
So I got to tune in every week. Like,
okay.
That was draining too, because every episode, it's like every episode I'm getting more bookings, more followers, more haters, more lovers, more people talking about it, more people bashing, more people loving me. Like, all these motherfucking opinions and all these comments and shit just off of one show. Sometimes I would be like, bro, what the fuck did I get myself into? But then I'm like, you know what? God allowed me to come on this show to make a difference and show people something different than what they have seen. Because if you really look at all the Bad Boys cast members, I stick out from all of them. I ain't even talking about how I look. Like,
right.
I stick out from all of the niggas, bro. Maybe, I don't know. Yeah, I stick out for sure. None of them niggas like me, bro. Even they so-called straight niggas, they not stiff like me. And I'm a Texas nigga. I'm from H. We cut different, bro.
I love how comedy people are on this show, though. You know, some people, you know, straight guys, they feel funny being in a room with a whole bunch, you know.
Well, I'm going to speak on that. Like, that's another reason why God allowed me to be on this show. Because you got to understand, a lot of niggas out here who signing your chick, them niggas gay. The people who own your house is gay. Your boss is probably gay. So it's like, why hate them? If they just like us, bro. They just like what they like. As long as it's respect, just keep it respectful, bro. Do that shit over there. You know what I'm saying? Don't disrespect me. At the end of the day, we are still men. I will still beat that ass. So they don't play with me. I don't play with them, but people need to stop discriminating, bro. It's 2023. Like, I can't be mad at these people for being my fans and wanting to fuck with me. You know what I'm saying? And I'm getting paid off this shit. Like, I might as well, but I gotta embrace them and fuck with them and take pictures with them when I go out, when I'm hosting the clubs. Like, it don't make me no different, but it did take me time to get comfortable. Like, cause I had to be a full man. Like, when I was a little younger, I probably wasn't ready for shit like that, but man, can't nobody tell me shit. Like,
right now.
Man, I'm grown ass, man.
Oh, you out here now.
I'm solidified. Like, say what you want, think what you want. God bless you. God bless you. Because I'm blessed, bro. I can't even describe how blessed I am. Like, God is good. But I feel like he let me go on that show to bring a different light to that show. And I for sure did that shit.
Definitely.
For sure.
How do you handle all the women? On your top.
I've been handling that shit. It ain't nothing new. A lot of this shit not nothing new. The only thing that changed is the fame. Like, I've been getting money. I've been Mocity Jaybee since, 2013?
Talk about it.
Yep. I've been Mocity Jaybee. You know what I'm saying? 2013, I've been pretty famous. I've been known on the internet and going viral on multiple platforms. You know what I'm saying? Twitter, Tumblr, all the old shit. People tell me, they be like, bro, you one of the first niggas I ever seen, like, just go viral off a fucking picture. That's why I started modeling. Oh, I'm a professional signed published model.
And you are. I was getting to that.
People don't know that. Like, my first real modeling job, besides the Instagram and all that shit, that was a nationwide. That was a nationwide deal. I didn't even know. They picked me out of a lot of people to represent their company, ASICS, and Foot Action everywhere around the world. In every Foot Action, every store. And I was only 21.
So did people reach out to you, or is that what you wanted to do?
No, I was already modeling. I walked into a modeling agency and got signed on the spot. And I'm not the tallest. I got tattoos. I was breaking the barriers. Like, I'm always the one to, like, kind of start breaking some barriers of things. Like, whether it's modeling or rapping or going on a show like that, or, you know what I'm saying, going on a show and talk about God, I'm one of them.
Ha.
For real.
Not out here.
But yeah, I was on the storefront. I was in the store. Yeah, everywhere. People was calling me and telling me, and I didn't believe them. So I went to this Galleria Mall in my city where I'm from, and I seen it myself. I was like, damn, this shit crazy. And I was only 21.
Wow.
And that was like 4 years ago. And just now I'm on TV and shit, like, it's hard work, just believing in God. Like, I know I was gonna be on TV one day, and I knew people was gonna fuck with me when I got home. So at this point in my career, I knew it was time to make that chess move for sure.
Facts.
If I turned down the show, for sure.
So what advice can you give people out here that, you know, wanna do this and that, wanna be on TV, but they feel like they got lots of to go.
It can happen for anybody. Sometimes it's who you know, being in the right place at the right time. Just don't ever stop working, because you never know where you're going to go with your shit. And it's saying in the Bible that God working in our favor no matter what. So if you try and you put in that work and you believe, you know, I can't even see what I'm going to get, but I'm just working. And then I'm meeting my destiny at the same time. Like, I mean, it can happen for anybody. Anybody. Like, but it's on you to put in that work, though. You got to work. I didn't put in some work. People think I got that privilege, that pretty thing. Nah, nigga,
you been working.
I came from my own way. For real. All
right, yo, well, we about to go and have a little bit of fun. When we come back, we gonna play a little bad boys game. We gonna see what JB know about his cast member. So we'll be right back. We're gonna fill these cups. You all fill them cups at home, too.
Let's do it. Retsu Wines by Amberella comes in a variety of flavors. Freshly crafted and guaranteed to bring out your sexy. Now back to the show.
And we back. Amberella and Momo. JB, y'all. Don't be seeing him in the streets being like, Momo, that's my fucking name. Thank you. Anyway, so yes, I told y'all we gonna play a game, the bad boys game. I'ma see how well JB knows his castmates.
I don't know them niggas. I might know them a little bit just from being around. I was around them.
You might know these. These are easy. All right, so which bad boy noticed every single motherfucking detail on the show?
Probably Prince.
Like, shit you would never notice. So A, Darrell, B, Prince, or C, Adonis?
Prince.
That nigga had me dying the whole season.
Prince cool, bro. He cool.
He noticed everything. When, what's his name? I can't get his name right. Ara. When he jumped in the damn pool.
Yeah.
Only Prince would be like, you got your mic on. Nigga, what?
I think that's just him. Like, that's just his personality. Like, a lot of times, I just ain't give a fuck. Like, I was just there.
Yeah.
Like, I'm just there.
You could tell. Like, oh, you were chilling for real.
But in person, that's how I am too. But I can still turn up and have a good time.
Yeah, I fuck with it. You could tell though. Yeah. All right, so which bad boy was the softest? A, Orlando, B, Razz, or C, Ara? That's hard.
I mean,
that's hard.
If you say the softest, I ain't gonna lie, I thought you was gonna put Carry On up in there. But
why
I forget about Razz? You say you don't like Razz B.
Can't stand him. I hate him in B2K when I was a child.
I don't remember that shit. So I don't know. But I ain't gonna lie, when we was filming, bro did think he was calling some shots like he was B2K days, and we all like, nigga, don't nobody give a fuck.
Razz B, you didn't call the shots in B2K. Omarion did. Like,
oh. Man, I ain't gonna lie. In person, go somewhere where them people treat him like a celebrity.
For real?
Yes. Jonathan and Riley. Okay, while we was filming, of course people knew me, but like I wasn't at the level of Jonathan and shit. Like, he's nationally known.
Yeah.
They will be screaming for them.
Right.
They be looking at us. Of course, they were fucking with me because I'm OCJ, but I look good, woo-woo. But now it's crazy. But yeah, they would scream for Rasby, Jonathan, and really. Oh, and they would always scream for, I'm always calling Eddie, Orlando.
Always scream for him. Well, always. Yeah. That's a Raven in the house.
I got a video of him dancing to the That's a Raven theme song, and I'm never sending it to nobody. That's mine, bro. Because on the bus, I ain't gonna lie, some of the best times we had was after we went out and filmed in the bus ride home. We would be fucked up.
They got me fucked up.
Oh my God. It would be so funny. And I want to say shout out to Zoo because they feed us every meal. We have so much food, and they don't be hungry. Breakfast, lunch, dinner, and food after club.
So y'all never was eating from food after the club?
Never.
That's the best.
Snacks, food, liquor in the house every single day. We never went without nothing. Every meal, they texting us every day, like, put in your order.
Which one? Yes.
Every place. It was, That's what I miss.
You know, you come up
with
food.
Yeah, staying in them nice ass houses. I miss that shit. I ain't gonna lie. That shit was like, that's the blessing in that shit. Like, that was some of the pros.
Yeah.
In filming the shit. Like, the cribs, the service.
Right.
The producers was nice. Oh, and I tell people this, it's always like 60 people around you. 10 niggas you shooting with, and behind them cameras, everybody looking at you is white. It's about like 10 producers. It's about like 10, 12 cameramen, it's about 20 security, and just probably people, assistants helping and walking around. It's about 50 to 60 people. Every scene you see is people standing behind them cameras.
So who's not going to make it for real?
Yes.
Damn!
I ain't gonna lie, when I went there, I'm like, these motherfuckers got money.
For real.
This type of shit that they doing for us and shit. Just how they moving and the shit that I'm hearing. I'm like, oh, right. They playing with some real bands. Like, this ain't a few bands, 10 to 20. No, they playing with packs. Like, it's non-stop for them. Like, they can take a $1 million loss. Like, they
good.
And they making bread. They making bread off us.
Facts. I'm talking bread.
The bread that they paid me, they made back, like, the first episode. Like, I got paid more off the show than what they paid me. I made my own bread more off the show than what they gave me.
Oh, fuck that.
But they still paid me good. But it's like,
I believe it.
When you ain't really got, like, if you haven't been on TV yet, you're not finna go on TV and just get a big ass check for your first time. Like, it's gonna be a nice check, but it ain't gonna be like a nigga, it ain't gonna be a Rasby check.
Right.
You know, even though he laying on.
Hell, please.
It ain't gonna be an Orlando chick. It ain't gonna be a Jonathan chick.
Yo, Momo really trying to convince me that Rasby's kind of that nigga. Like, no.
Nah, I didn't say he was that nigga. I just say he cool. He a nice person. Like, he genuine. If he came in here right now, he would be very nice to you.
He seems salty on the show. That's why I'm like, oh, I'm going home.
When they put them cameras on, niggas get this.
Changing.
I'm like this on any camera anyway. Like, I mean.
This all topic. We should even food.
Mexican food.
For real?
Yeah,
yeah.
Mexican food is so good.
Mexican
food. You said Mexican food?
Mexican food.
I love Mexican food. Tacos is way to my heart for sure.
What's your race?
I'm black.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, my parents just look nice. I'm fully black.
Facts. Yeah, my friends be like, Esmo, his parents are because he
I posted them. I had to post them. I look just like my dad. I ain't gonna lie. My mama is very pretty with nice hair.
Oh.
And my pops, you know what I'm saying, is a good looking dude with nice. I look just like him. And he had a baby with my pretty ass mama. And people don't even know. I got a twin sister. Yeah,
do it's you? A girl person,
and she live. And I got three big sisters. I'm the only boy.
So it's 5 year old.
So I come from a big family. Like, people don't even be knowing that shit.
I love that.
My parents was married for 20 plus years.
Like, I hate being the only child.
You're the only child? Damn.
Oh, I hate it for real. I be like, damn.
Nah, I can't. I was born into an already family. Like, we was the last two.
Right.
I got big sisters. They took care of me. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
When I got older, I lived with them for a little bit. You know? It was live.
Fuck with it.
Yeah.
All right, let's get back to the game. All right. Which bad boy has security chasing him down the street at one of y'all's club appearances?
Who was that? What? Jonathan? I ain't gonna lie. Look, that's my nigga, but he's so unpredictable.
That shit was funny as hell. Oh my God.
You gotta watch. Hey.
I think I rewinded it about 3 times.
I had one home that night. I didn't see that shit.
Oh, okay.
I had one home that night. We had a dark day. I had got into it with one of the owners. And I had one home that day. I was like, fuck y'all.
Oh, man.
And they was like, nah, nigga, come back to the show, you tripping. I'm like, I'm coming back. I gotta finish my show. I gotta get my second deposit.
Right. Well, whatever. You just
want
to go home for a little bit.
Oh my God. Bro, I'm telling you.
Man, and how long y'all take for?
A whole month of March.
A whole month of March.
30 days. Damn. 30 fucking days being with the people, bro.
Right.
Some of the good days was the dark days too when we didn't film. You could do your own thing. That was fun.
Right.
But
it's just
so tense because when the cameras come on, you never know what's gonna happen.
Right.
It's just crazy. But I always just over there in the back. I mean, one night we had a meeting off camera and I came down with a white beat. I'm standing there, I'm just rocking back and forth. It's like the first day. I'm rocking back and forth. They're like, you good? Everybody can ask me, am I good? Because they think I'm finna punch off on one of them.
Right.
I'm like, bro, I'm straight, nigga. I'm just watching y'all niggas, bro. I don't know none of you niggas, fool. Like, I'm good. They're like, you straight? I'm like, nigga, I'm good. Mm-hmm. It make you be like real, like anxious. Like, you never know. Somebody might go upside your head.
Right.
For real.
Watch out for every motherfucking body.
But the female's worse, though. I don't even watch that shit, but the shit I see on the internet, mm-hmm. all they do is fight, bro.
I'd rather watch
all.
It's better. They be yapping. Man. I'm like, woo! Don't even shut up.
This shit crazy.
All right, last one then. Which bad boy was considered the finest?
Me?
A, Mocity Jaybee. B, Mocity Jaybee. C, Mocity Jaybee. Or D, all the above.
Oh, there you go. It ain't even that. Hey, I wouldn't even say I'm the finest. Like, that's weird to say. I'm the livest nigga.
The
livest. Hey, other niggas might try to claim that title. I let the people say what they want and think what they want.
And the people gonna say one day, Mocity Jaybee.
I told them, I'm like, bro, I think y'all need to make me a trophy. Go ahead and make me an award because in the bad boys history, ain't nobody fucking with me, bro. Like, it's just, I'm gonna be honest. Somebody say, bro, I need to give you an award. Nigga, you came and changed the game. A lot of them be like, nigga, fuck what you did, nigga. Look at you, nigga. I'm gonna fuck you. I'm like, bro, I was still off on you too. You mad about me stealing off on niggas you don't know. We do not know you.
Right.
If I stole him for no reason, I will steal off on your ass.
So,
it's
on your line.
Watch your back.
All right, Mo, you ever been behind the bar before?
Yes. I'm actually, you know, in my off time. No, man, if I'm so broke, I have to go bartend. I'm a bartender, y'all.
No.
I be bartending for real, real life down in Houston. Y'all come find me, man. You know what I'm saying?
Where at? The house.
Nah, but I'm the nigga at the party that is passing the bottles and the drinks out, trying to get everybody fucked up, make sure everybody having a good time. So, yeah.
All right, well, guess what? You about to add mixologist to your list of everything that you do. Rapper, entrepreneur, savage, reality star, everything.
Damn.
So.
I gotta make a drink, right?
Yeah, you do. So we about to play Garnish or Tarnish, okay? So I'm gonna give you a list of items. It's kind of like a this and that.
Okay.
You're going to tell me which one you prefer, and the ones that you pick will go into your signature cocktail, okay?
Oh, shit. And then I got to drink it.
And you got to drink it, and I'm going to judge it, and if it's banging, you can name it. It's yours.
Okay, good.
Bet?
Yeah.
All right. First one, Crown Vanilla or Tequila Vodka?
Crown Vanilla.
Number two, Vanilla Ice Cream or Vanilla Extract?
Vanilla ice cream.
Three, Coke or cream soda?
Coke.
Four, you gonna garnish it with whipped cream or you gonna garnish it with a cinnamon stick?
Mm. Is it like a churro cinnamon stick or is
it's
like
not? A... It's just it's a what, real
what,
cinnamon stick.
What was the other option?
Oh, whipped cream.
Whipped cream.
All right, y'all. So. I'm about to go sit up this bar for JB, and we gonna see what his bartending skills is looking like. So we be right back.
This episode of Amberella's World features Crown Royal Vanilla. What's dessert with this creamy vanilla finish? Now back to the show.
All right, y'all, we back. So we about to test Momo on his bartending skills. He said, you know, he passed the bottles in the club and shit, but now we got shit on making a banging ass drink. So let's see what he gonna do, y'all. All right, Mo, so you said vanilla ice cream, whipped topping, crown royal vanilla, and coke.
Yes.
That already sound banging, so let's do this. So You gotta do the ice cream first. You put the ice cream in the cup.
In both of the cups?
Yes. Because I want to taste it too.
I ain't never put no ice cream in my, so it's gonna be like a.
We about to see.
Should I put more than that?
Yeah, put a little more than that. Stick it to it. I don't want to touch it. How, do you like ice cream?
Hey, yeah.
Oh, okay.
I smoke it. I'll be high as hell. I'll be having fun. Yeah. Ice cream
is eating. Fat.
But I wouldn't just eat vanilla. I like chocolate, cookies and cream. I like sherbet ice cream.
Yeah, I love butter pecan.
I like butter pecan. Pecan. We say pecan.
Pecan? Oh, shit. Not you about to have me back in PA saying pecan.
Y'all say pecan?
Pecan.
Fuck, no, that shit is bad. Pecan.
Pecan. Pecan. Every time I eat it, I'm drinking your ass. All right, look. In a shaker.
We talk a little different down here. How much to put in here?
Whatever you think. You're the mixologist now. You're taking over my job. Good? Yeah. All right. We're going to shake that up so we can chill a bit.
Shake up a, look at the crown?
Yep, figure that out really good. Yep, because we can't shake it with the soda because you know that'll burst your head.
Okay, okay.
Yeah, just open this up.
I never used one of these before.
Good. Using the first time with me. Go ahead, pour up. Pull up.
Not really pull. You ever sit lean? I like to sit lean.
For real? Yeah. I ain't never had that before. How can we do?
Great.
For real?
Lovely. You're going to get the best sleep of your fucking life.
What's the difference between that and smoking?
If they both downers. Do both. I do both together.
For real? You be chilling.
I be in a coma.
Oh, shit. But I'm scared I'm going to die or something.
Nah,
I'll be good.
It's not even that type of drug. It's literally like liquid weed. Like, you just on a... Your body just feels so good. Oh, my God.
Is it different type of high?
You be fighting your sleep, though. You're going to be tired as fuck.
So I need to do it in the house. Mm-hmm. Not in the club.
Yeah. You do it in the club.
Pour up a little bit of coke.
Pour it on the side. You feel me?
All right.
Yeah, I know this. I'm
sorry. Yeah, you do. Okay. And yeah, we're going to top it off with some what?
Top it off?
Off.
Off.
Now, Mo, usually during this segment, since I interviewed this whole time, you get to put me in the hot seat and ask me anything you want.
Oh, shit. For real?
Yeah.
Right now?
Yeah.
All right, bet. I see. So when did you start doing what you're doing right here?
Okay, so I went to school for broadcast and media production. Mm-hmm. I graduated with a bachelor's degree. I just knew I was going to be on TV. I do.
Damn.
Well, because I thought I would have never went if I knew I could do this without it. I'm going to tell you that.
She changed it.
Yeah, because I could save you some motherfucking money.
Yeah, that's what the white people try to tell you to do.
That's what I'm saying. I'm like, yo, fuck that. That's what I'm telling everybody. You ain't got no school. Don't even go.
I never had a college class. I never went to a college campus. I never signed up for college.
It's a joke.
Thanks. My sisters in college and made it out of college and they got degrees and they got good jobs, but
yeah,
I can make their salary in a year.
That's what I'm saying.
Going on TV.
Right. You're crazy. But yeah, so I did that and then I worked for the news. Mm-hmm. I was doing that shit. I was a news anchor. And then I wanted to advance in my career, but they just wanted me to stay right where I was at.
Hell no.
So I said, fuck that, left it. I bartended for like 10 years.
A lot of women bartend. It's easy money. Fast money.
Easy, fast as fuck.
My sister bartending.
But that's it. You want to make the fucking bread.
If you look good, you're going to make the bread.
Yes. And then I said, you know what, fuck this. I think my own show.
Thanks.
I did this concept. No one's doing this. No one's fucking doing this.
I watched the shit. I did my research and my homework. I do my research and homework on everybody before I pull up on
it. Yeah, I fuck with that, bro. Because some people don't.
Let's
cheers. Let's try it. All right. Let's try it, y'all.
It's good. It's but good. You gotta try to get all of it at the same time.
I know.
Making no ice cream.
Shit, we need a straw.
Yeah, or a spoon.
Or a spoon. Here.
Fact, you know what? Spoon. Try to whip it like.
Yeah. Look at the rest.
Yeah, now it's like a little milkshake. A little crown milkshake.
Yeah. I'm fucking with it.
Let me see what it's here for.
What other icing would you put in here? Or you just do vanilla?
Pecan.
Pecan. He gets on my nerves, dog.
I ain't gonna lie, it's pretty good.
It's good, right? Oh, especially when you get the whip.
Mm. It tastes like a spiked root beer float or something.
Mm-hmm.
It's pretty good.
It definitely hits, though. It's good. But now you gotta name it. What do you wanna name it? Because it's your name.
Pecan.
Mom, you get on my damn nerves. Pecan.
The pecan most special. This is the pecan most special.
The pecan most special. Oh, I fuck with it. It's different. No, for real.
I ain't gonna lie, it's good. I'm gonna finish it for sure.
Alright, y'all. Me and Mom gonna finish up our pecan Mocity Jaybee break. Thank you for coming to hang out with your girl and drink with me.
I finished my shit. It's really good.
It done?
I ain't an alcoholic, but when I do drink, I like to drink. When I smoke, I be smoking.
Period. All right, y'all. I hope y'all enjoyed looking at Mo, because shit, I did. Now, love y'all. See y'all in the next episode.
Bye, y'all.
We want some. We want some. We want some.